This is Ronaldo with LearnCG, and I'm going to take you on implementing the animated score counter in effects script, and we'll look at just basic implementation and potential issues that you can have with implementing. First things first, chances are you'll be Frankensteining a project. I call it Frankensteining using assets from the asset store. So you have your base kit. It's something either you bought or developed, and you want to make an improvement. Perhaps you have a minimum viable product, and it's pretty solid, and you just want to add a little extra juice to your project. So this is a perfect example. Here we have a motorcycle with the ability to collect coins, and this could be a casual game, or the score counter script was initially, at least the particle portion, was initially created for casual and casino games. So this allows you to add extra pizzazz to collecting score, since this is usually the main function of the user, the big enjoyment for the end user. So here we have in this case a motorcycle collecting coins, and let's check out what we have. The screen. Boop. And you can see that once the bike hits the coin, once the collision occurs, you can see that we have the coin disappearing and the score incrementing. Right now we have 1100 points up on the board. So you get the kit, and how should you implement? Well, first things first, you need to figure out where your text GUI is. In this case, my text GUI is up here on the upper right-hand corner, and I have default 500 printed in here. So with this, the first thing you want to do, you want to add the score counter effects script to this text object. And you need to also make sure that you have a GUI scripted text GUI script here. So in this case, we have this in place. So whatever's in here by default will be replaced by the animated score script. So to move forward, to move forward from here, we'll need to identify within the script itself, within the core project, how the score is implemented. How does the score increment using the default process? So in this case, since the trigger is a collision, we need to inspect the two items, either the bike or the coin. So let's check out what's in here. Let's check out what's in this coin. There we go. Let's undo. So we have the coin, and let's inspect for any scripts that look like it's going to give us the functionality that we need. We'll go down a bit, and we have interactable object. This looks promising. We have 100 points, so most likely there is a trigger in here. So there is a listener listening to the collision, and that is right here. Yeah. On trigger enter 2D. So this is looking for collisions that are happening on this object, and we run this function here, the check for biker. This is a custom function that was created by the developer. And here we'll go down a bit. Let's see what this does. It does a bunch of things here. But if we look here, we have if the score is above zero. So if we score point, we look in the gameplay manager script, and we're looking for the apply score method within this script, and then we pass it the score. So this seems positive. So plus score is actually what was in here. So plus score is right here. So we just pass whatever is in the inspector. So that's cool. And what I would do to implement the script as fast as possible, I would right-click here, then go to declaration. So once you find what is the trigger, you go ahead and open that up, and here is that method. And the easiest way to implement is to first comment out the part where it's updating the text, the next GUI. So here we have score table. So we need to find the gameplay manager to see where this score table is. Is it hard coded or is it exposed in the inspector? So let's go ahead and check that out. Score table is not what I need. I need the gameplay manager. Gameplay manager. We'll click that. I was able to find it. And it does look like, whoop, it's right here. And score table is right there. So this is actually the score table, and this is the reference of the score table. So cool. It's working with the inspector. So that's perfect. So instead of using this, we will actually copy this here. I'll comment it out and copy. We're going to use this same exact function. We're going to get the get component, but instead of accessing the text object or the text script, we're going to access the custom script that we have here. Well, that's part of our package. So if we look down here, instead of accessing this script, we're going to access the score counter effects script. So we'll go ahead and put in score counter effects instead of text. And the method that we want is the increment score. And the score here will take a float. So we're going to pass it plus score. We'll save. We'll save that to our project, and then we'll run it. So in this case, the while this is loading, let's see, the score table here, there are a bunch of settings here. Right now they're set to default. You can control these. You can control these for your needs. You have how many digits should be in the padding. So in this case, we're not using padding, but we could. And we can look at these. I'll have another video that will go through all of these settings here. But right now, what's most important is taking a look at the score. Right now, it's prefixed with score, which is right here. That's great. And if you look at the score, once I collect the coins, it should increment by 10. As we expected. So this is the simple implementation, and this is the method that I would recommend for implementing MyScript into your project. So you're Frankensteining, find what is the trigger for adding points, and then replace the base, replace the default score mechanism with My mechanism, and this will allow you to keep track of score. Now this is the basic implementation. Now if you want to add particles, which is the more advanced, you just need to change what you pass to the object, what you pass to the increment score instead of a float value for the score that you want to increment, you need to pass it an object. And that object, let's see here, I have one pre-made. Down here, there is a particle settings script, a class, a particle settings class that I created, and it has you can pass it a few different. If we look here, let's look at particle settings. And you see here we have a few constructors for this class. For the most part, you'll need a start position. You need to know where the particle is going to emit from. You'll need a goal object. This is an object that the particles will extract the location from. So by default, this used to be a vector, but a goal object allows the target to move, and then the particle will chase that. So that's a nice effect. And here we have a vector 2 for the size range. There's a range so that you can add a little variance to your particles, which is a nice effect. It makes things more dynamic and adds more depth to the project. And the same is for velocity. So size range is the size of the particles. Velocity is how fast the particle is going to go. So this is only the speed. It's not going to control the direction at all. The particle does that automatically. The next one is how many points to add to the project. So instead of going through this list, let's actually go through and do this and actually implement it. So let's go into here and look. So, under the Gameplay Manager, we need to create a new particle settings, which we actually have here. So, the easiest way for me to implement it, to add the particles, is to create a new variable that is of type particle settings. So, if I hover here, this should be a particle settings. Not working for some reason right now. So we want a new particle settings, and we pass it a valid constructor set. So if we go ahead here and let's see, I open this up, you can see that I have four different constructors, and you can just hit the down arrow to pass it the right information. So the easiest of the two, well, there's four different constructors, but you have animated and static. So right now we're just covering the static one and the animated. So here is static, and this one's animated. The main difference being the you need to specify the number of tiles in X and Y. And this is just describing how your sprite sheet is set up. So what we'll do, we'll go ahead and just use the default, what I have already created here. So I like, when doing the particles, I like to create variables separately here and then pass it into my particle settings object so that it's easier. I can just look here and see what the values are, and if I needed to change it, I can go ahead and change it here. All of the demo scripts that I provided you for you are done this way, where in either a public variable, you can modify the values in the inspector, or you go into your code and you can modify them here. So right now I have the size, the speed, the rate, and right here the target is going to be the score table. Actually, this is going to be the only value that I'll change. Let me change this one and I'll do goal target. Let me make a public variable, so we'll do goal target, and we'll save that out and add a goal target here. I like to keep the target for the score separate from the score itself, so we'll go ahead and do that. So I'll create a new text, we'll take a new image object. Put this here, and for the image, let's see if we can find the coin. We'll use this coin for the target, so I guess this makes the most sense. We'll do this, and then we'll just slide this over. Cool. So now I have a target here, and within, looks like I have an error here. So we'll go to our script. We need the Gameplay Manager. And here, there should be a new, oh, it's not going to show up because I have a compile error. So let's go ahead and see where where I messed things up. So I don't need to, we have the increment score here, and right here is the issue. So let me just comment this out, or we have the value here already. So let's just add the gold target, and then put that in. So I was being a little sloppy there. So now there should be no more errors. And once it recompiles, we can look here. We'll have the ability to drop in this new object. Gold target is on the bottom. Let's close this out. Zoom out. Find this coin. What is this called? It's just called image. I'll name it gold target. Let's actually name it gold target. There we go. Close that out, and now we'll just drag this into the inspector. Let's first refocus the view onto the gameplay manager. I'm going to lock it here so that I can actually grab the gold target and drag it in without losing focus within the inspector, and then just drag and drop. So now when I run the script, you'll see that we're able to collect coins, and the coins are going to go to here, to this coin. I don't have any anchoring set up. This is just the demo, but let's see. Help if I use the correct method. So in this case, in the interactable objects here, we'll look and we'll see. We see that we have apply score, which is not what we want. Let's use this one. Let's use apply ASC, and this is going to use the particle settings. Particle settings. This is exactly where the particle settings live. So we'll use that method instead. I could have easily just copied and pasted, but for the example here, I kept things separate so that I could provide this code to anyone who needed to see an explicit example between the differences on how to update their pre-existing code. So we'll save that, and then we'll let me change the size here. Cool, and then we'll let's get things going right. So here we need to add this dot transform dot position. This method needs a vector and the score. So we'll go ahead and do that. And we'll hit play. So now when we go, the particles, they're focused, their target is this coin here. So what I can do is, let's see, I'll restart. I'll take the game menu, I'll put it over here so we can have a view. We'll hit play. So I have the scene view here, and I'll go ahead and move the target in real time. So let's, the particles are moving pretty fast, so I'm not sure how that will work, but let's see. So now you can see that the particles, they are in real time following their goal. Which is a recent change within the script. Before I used the static vector, but using the game object, you can go ahead and have that effect. Now, when you're Frankensteining, there is an issue that you can have, and this is a problem with your implementation. If you have both scripts running, so somehow you have the original legacy score script running, and you only wanted to use the score counter script on a certain occasion, then you might run into an issue that the score counter script resets your score. So you have your base script that's updating your score, and then you'll have the score counter script trigger on whatever your condition was, and then the score starts to increment from zero again. This is not something that I've come across personally. This is something that a customer did mention. I don't know their exact use case or what their scene is, but I tried to come up with a particular use case, and this is as close as I could get for that particular example. So here, if you look, we have another method here, the apply score or ACS. So I have a Boolean that is triggered after a certain score has been met. Once that condition has been met, I'll switch from the default score keeping to the animated score counter. And in here I have a typo. So we'll copy that. We'll go inside interactable object. We'll use apply score or animated score counter. We'll hit save. And let's see. This doesn't exist, so I should probably save here. Let's see if that fixes it. So it's working now. I'll go forward. And the score should use the legacy system at first. Probably still is. I did update the legacy score. Let's see. Yeah. So let's bring in the legacy score counter in place. And let's see. So what we're looking for is the score to increment just by hundreds, the old boring way, and after a few hundred points to switch over, we should have some feedback in debug triggered, so we can see messages here, and then you'll see it reset. The score resets to zero and then increments. Have 400, they're coming in, they're incrementing. Score reset here, and then we have a trigger. We switched to ASC for score keeping, and now it increments up to that point. So that's a problem with implementation. If you run into this issue, again, it depends on your use case. So you can just drop me an email at admin@learncg.net, and I can look at your example. But if you're running into this issue, the chances are you are using two different methods or two different methods for updating the GUI text, and you should only use the score counter script. And yeah, once you only implement one score counter script, you should not have an issue. So cool. If you have any questions, please let me know, and I'll see you soon. Thank you very much. Cheers. Bye.